many students think that angles with longer arms always have greater degree measure than angles with shorter arms. Let us take an example and try to understand this misconception. Two angles are shown on the screen, an acute angle with long arms and an obtuse angle with shorter arms. Students who have this misconception will say that the acute angle with long arms has greater degree measure than the obtuse angle with short arms. They say so because instead of comparing the spread of the arms or the turn of the arm, they actually compare the length of the arms of the two angles. Let's look at a few questions from MindSpark which capture this misconception. Which of the two angles shown below has greater measure? Option A is B is greater because its arms are longer. Option B is both have the same measure because the spread of the arms is the same. What do you think is the correct answer to this question? Clearly, the correct answer to this question is option B. Both have the same measure because the spread of the arms is the same. What do you think is the percentage of students who opted option A as their answer? Let's take a look at the performance data of this question. 11,663 students attempted this question, out of which 25% students, or 2,893 students, chose option A as their answer, while 75% of the students chose option B as their answer, which shows us the extent of the misconceptions among students. Let's take a look at another MindSpark question which captures this misconception. Which of the two angles shown below has greater measure? Option A is greater because its arms are longer. Option B is greater because the spread of its arms is more. What do you think is the correct answer to this question? Clearly, option B is greater because the spread of its arms is more, is the correct answer to this question. What do you think is the percentage of students who opted A as their answer? Let's take a look at the performance data of this question. 11,805 students attempted this question, out of which 74%, or 8,748 students, answered the question correctly, while 3,057 students, or 26% of the students, chose option A as their answer. Now let us discuss some of the remediation techniques which the teachers can use in the classrooms to remedy this misconception. Many students have a wrong notion of the concept of angles, which arises due to a lack of exposure to angles. Teachers are advised to use several examples from daily life involving angles while teaching angles in the classroom, such as the spokes of a giant wheel, the hands of a clock, the lid of a box, etc. Instead of defining angles in its static form as two rays originating from a vertex, teachers are advised to use the turn definition of angle, which is more intuitive for the child's understanding. Also, teachers should encourage the students to use tracing papers for comparison of angles, where they can superimpose one angle on top of the other angle to compare it. Let us see how we can do this using a tracing paper. This is a tracing paper. We place the tracing paper on top of one of the angles and draw its outline. We then place the tracing paper on top of the other angle to compare with it. We see that the acute angle turns lesser than the obtuse angle, despite the fact that the acute angle has longer arms and the obtuse angle has shorter arms. We can clearly see that the obtuse angle has greater degree measure.